So last year we went to a new spot in Kansas, and it was with Rawhide Outfitters, and I used to have a bunch of ground in Kansas lost, and I've been looking for like a good spot back in Kansas. And so they're just big landowners that have a great outfit there. And so I was like, I'm gonna go, you know, try it. So we hunted a couple days, and so we saw some big deer. And obviously Outfitters, they have lock-ons and sets, and they're sending you these sets. And it's not really my favorite way to hunt whitetails. You know, I like kind of going and doing it. But I got nowhere in Kansas, so. And it was a great spot, and their stuff's in great sets. The problem is, as an outfitter, you're sending 10 guys in there in a 2-week span. They don't know what those guys are doing in there, you know, how many deer they've spooked, you know, all that stuff. But long story short, it's like day 3, and I'm hunting a deer. It's a giant 9 with about a 3-inch drop on one side. And we're in the bottom, a bottom lock-on set on a food plot, and I see him chasing does. He comes out of the saddle, like this big CRP saddle that hooks into these big white oak ridges. He comes right through the saddle, chases does around several hundred yards away, goes back up through the saddle. Every buck that come through this little saddle. And so the next day the wind was changing, and we go around up top, and Lexi drops it off on the lock-on, and Hunter Phelps was filming me, and so he had his saddle and I had mine just in case, and he couldn't get in a tree where the lock-on was, which I knew we were not gonna kill that buck from there, you know. And so Lexi's like 10 minutes away now. I call her, I say, hey, I need to move. Like, there's no way we can get in this tree. She said, go wherever you need to go, you know? So I was like, oh, that was the best. That's the best news I've heard all night. All right, so last night, guys, we were right here and we could see him. He come out of here down this road that we're walking down right now. You can see where our blue dot is. So he come out of here last night, chased does. And I feel like they're checking from this plot to this plot. They're using this road right here. We saw several deer do that buck, so we're gonna try to get in this saddle. I marked where we need to be, and hopefully there's a tree right there to get in. But we got a pretty good wind for it.
We dive off this hill, we both got our saddles, and we get down to this, you know, gap where these deer are coming out of the timber. And of course there's no trees to get in to shoot. Like, the tree line is so brushy with overhangs, like, yeah. I could have only shot in one spot and we'd have never seen them coming. But there's one little like scrub tree that's like as big around as my leg, and like I can't get more than 10 feet high in it, you know, and there's no way we're both getting in it. So I was like, dude, getting that big white oak back there, I'm getting in this thing. And I used one step and got on limbs and went up about 9 feet, you know. Awesome. And I got in it and I'm like, this could work. But you know, if I move, the whole tree is like, so I'm like, I have to be a ninja, you know, like
typical Kansas is.
Oh yeah. And so I'm like, okay. And so Hunter gets back here, wind's good, so we're sitting there. And
all right, guys, we brought the saddles. Made a move on the drop giant 9 that we saw last night down here. Just a real massive 9-point, about a 3-inch drop, ready to pounce. So maybe we see him tonight. I hope so.
Young 8-point comes out. Literally, he's got pictures. I think I sent you of this 8-point standing like under my feet. I'm like, oh, this is awesome, you know, this is sick. And then another mature deer comes right down and right in front of me, and I'm like, this is it, you know. And it was like getting late. I'm like, dang it, you know, I can't believe this deer didn't show. And I think Hunter was about to pack up, and I look up and I see this buck coming from the opposite way, but coming still through the same gap. I pull my binos up and I'm like, it's him. And he's on the trail that's like 6 yards from this tree, and I'm like 8 foot up, you know. And it was probably the most primitive feeling hunt I've ever done, just because I felt like I was like, I could have stabbed him, you know? And like, I get Hunter's attention, he's rolling on this buck coming. It was just dead quiet. And like, the buck heard me draw. Like, I get like halfway and he like kind of stops and I'm like froze. He's that point blank. Like, I wouldn't even have to look through my peep. Like, just, he's that close. We just killed the big nine.
We just smoked him. Holy smoke, listen. Oh my God. The one buck I wanted to kill him. Check out this setup.
Smoked him, you know? It was just this craziest feeling of, and we would have never got that done. Anything but a saddle, you know. Like, and I'm 8 feet off the ground, so I can like see him breathing, you know. It was just
such a drag.
Oh yeah. And it was like, holy cow. And just the sound of that arrow going through him so fast. It was just wild, but that was probably one of the coolest hunts I ever did. Just because I felt so exposed, but using that, even the limbs, and I could use the whole tree to hide behind. He had no clue. It was pretty.
What did the outfitter think of like when
they were like,
show you how you
feel, they come pulling up and they're like, you gotta be kidding.
Right.
Because
right?
I still left. I left the platform and they were like, you did not get in that tree. I swear, dude, that's where I killed it right there. And they're like, so I guess we need to stand here somewhere. I'm like,
yeah, there's no place to put it. Yeah, right.
Good luck. Bring a chainsaw, you know. Just climbed down. My arrow's like 7 yards from the tree, as you guys see. So he heard the deer crash. Definitely fell right here. He fell for like 5 minutes, but we'll get the arrow and get him loaded up. That's a good sign. Pretty awesome hunt tonight, I'll tell you that much. 70 degrees. Didn't matter. But just one of those deals, it was very situational, you know, like those bucks probably were only gonna do that for a couple of days till they get with a hot doe, hunting the conditions. Where if you got sets and that's not in the game, you're screwed, you know. But a saddle, you can really move conditionally, so.
That's awesome.